Hello, I'm Julian Kaltheiner and we'll present the appearance database of the University of Bonn. We start off with a problem that comparing appearance models is oftentimes very difficult, with the code or dataset sometimes unavailable, and the validation purely based on new measurements. A standardized benchmark for appearance modeling is missing so far, which would be needed for a fair and unbiased comparison between existing and new works. To fill this gap of a missing benchmark, we create one in direct connection to the dataset. Other datasets consist of non-spatially varying BRDFs or synthetic renderings of handcrafted SVBRDFs, while our dataset tries to bridge this gap of real-world and synthetic data with the help of measured reflectance images. The benchmark should be based on versatile materials, in this case many different kinds of fabrics. To make the results comparable, we post the benchmark as a competition, with some of the data not publicly released to guarantee a fair challenge condition. The real-world data of the dataset contains 434 unique fabrics, all captured with the XYTech7 scanner, capturing radiometrically calibrated and registered HDR images. For every single material, there are 668 real-world images, with 100 polychromatic and 568 panchromatic images. The panchromatic ones are divided into point-lit and line-lit images, and only point-lit images available for the polychromatic images. To capture the 100 polychromatic images, the scanner uses four different cameras with five light positions and five rotations of the turntable on which the material is mounted, resulting in these 100 different images. For the panchromatic pointlit images, the scanner took four different camera positions, 24 light positions and three turntable rotations to create these 288 panchromatic pointlit images per fabric. The 280 line-lit images for every material are created with the help of 4 cameras, 14 angle configurations and 5 turntable rotations. Outside of these HDR real-world images, the dataset also contains SVBRDF data of every fabric, created with the help of X-White's Pantora SVBRDF fits. It uses a single-lobe anisotropic Geissler-Moroder-Ward model with the SVBRDF stored in the appearance exchange format with a spatially varying Fresnel term, diffuse albedo, specular albedo, normal maps, as well as two-dimensional roughness values and anisotropy angles. The fabrics are pre-divided into training, validation and challenge dataset, which is used for the benchmark and displayed here. Additionally, each fabric is sorted into different fabric classes, showing the wide variety of fabric materials contained in our dataset. So how is this benchmark challenge formulated, as it tries to make models more fair and easily comparable? To do so, the participants of the challenge evaluate the model with the help of directionally sampled data, with us holding back 10% of the poly and panchromatic images for evaluation. The results are uploaded to an evaluation server, where the measurements and reconstructions are compared automatically, using a wide variety of metrics like the L1 or L2 error, or the SSIM for example. As shadowing and other non-local effects can have an impact on the results, we also use a weighted comparison with the pixel confidence provided by us to reduce the non-local effects with the pixel-wise weighting. The competition is open for everyone to participate and can be found under this URL. There you can find the direct as well as the weighted metric scores. Are there any more questions or suggestions? Did we miss some highly relevant metric or are there other baselines to add? If there is any other material class which we should add next, let us know.